Hi everybody, Joey here again and welcome back. So in today's video, I want to give you guys some ideas on building your own canister filter for your aquarium. This week I actually built a few. I first built a horizontal type that'll hang on the back of your tank, and then I also went ahead and built a heater into it. I also built a vertical style that you can sit beside your tank or hang it on the side or back of your tank as well. And then of course I did another version where I incorporated a heater into that as well. However, in today's video, I'm just gonna get you started with the vertical style. Now, if you want to see all of the other types, let me know in the comment section below and we can revisit this video in the future and I'll show you everything that I had done. However, once you see one done, you can easily do all of them. The vertical style not only allows you to hang it on the back, but also sit it beside your tank if that's what you'd like to do. But it also allows you to connect two or three in conjunction and daisy chain them, which will give you even further customization for your filtration needs. I will admit though that I do like the relatively small pump that it requires to power, because you could use something as small as a power head. Not only is this going to use lower wattage, but because it's hanging on the back or sitting beside the tank, whatever size pump you use, you're probably going to get roughly that out of the filter. As opposed to a typical canister filter, which would be underneath the tank and the water has to pump all the way to the top and you lose some flow there. The supplies I used to build the main components to the canister were a 4-inch thin wall PVC pipe, a 4-inch end cap, a 4-inch female adapter, a male cap, and a pair of do-it-yourself bulkheads that I showed you how to do in last week's video. One thing that I would like to note is that the end cap has a gasket already on it. If you can't find one like this, you could simply buy the cap and the gasket separate like I did here. Don't worry about color, we can change those later. Putting this together is simple. I put the bottom cap on first and drilled a hole for the 3/4-inch bulkheads into the side. The size of the hole needed will depend on the size of the fitting. I attached the bulkhead with the gasket on the inside. Since the bulkhead will be permanent, you can also silicone this in place instead of using a gasket if that's what you prefer. I did the same thing with the top cap and set it aside. Now, since I'll be adding loose media to this canister, I didn't want it to block the output. So I cut a small piece of PVC pipe taller than the actual bulkhead and cut a section out of it so it would slide right around it. I then cut a small piece of lighting diffuser to place on top of it, but you can use some mesh screening like I did in the original canister filter video that I showed you in the past. This will hold the media above the bulkhead and allow for unrestricted flow. I then placed the cap on. For the output, I used a couple small pieces of 3/4-inch PVC, a 3/4-inch PVC elbow, a 3/4-inch to half inch reducer, and a half inch 90 degree barb fitting. For the return, 4 pieces of 3/4-inch PVC and 4 3/4-inch PVC elbows. The top elbow was the same height as the input elbow. Now this is important if you intend to hang it on the back of your tank. At this point, I've invested around $20 in supplies. Most of the cost will be in that 4-inch PVC pipe. However, I bought 10 feet of it, so I basically have enough to build 6 of these canisters. Which brings up the point that if you want to save money by building your own canister filters, you're probably not going to do so if you only intend to build one. However, I must add that I personally rarely build something just to save money. For the most part, I build something just so I can get exactly what I want. Now, the last thing you might want to do is spray paint it, which gives it a more finished look. For this, I used Krylon Fusion spray paint and I used a flat black color. For media, I went with lava rock. I got 7 pounds for $5, a highly porous and long-lasting type of rock that serves as an excellent biological media. For mechanical, I went with some spare filter sponge I had and cut it to size of the pipe. Now, the way this works is simple. Water is pumped into the top of the filter and it's mechanically filtered first as it passes through that sponge, and then biologically filtered as the water passes through the lava rock, finally exiting at the bottom and pumped back up to the top of the tank. Now, since we are using a cap that twists on and off made waterproof by that gasket, we can get into the canister filter to clean it by simply disconnecting the pump and twisting the cap off. Now, you can position this canister filter beside your tank or hang it right on the back. That's really up to you. Now, you might be wondering what the weight of one of these things are, since an option is to hang it on your tank. And empty, they weigh about 3 pounds each. Once I filled it up with lava rock, they weighed 5 pounds each. And since they are packed with a lot of lava rock, there's not a ton of water that can really fit in here. So once it's filled with water, it only weighs about 10 pounds total. Now, that might sound like a lot of weight. However, in comparison to some hang on the back refugiums that you can buy that can weigh upwards of 20 and 30 pounds, this is not a big deal at all. You might also be wondering how to size them for your aquarium. And an easy rule of thumb that I like to go by is for every foot of canister, you could use it for a 30 to 50 gallon aquarium. Flow rates aim somewhere between 6 and 8 times per hour, which means that you'll be turning over the entire volume of your aquarium 6 to 8 times through that canister every hour. Now this is actually a very vague statement though, because not all bodies of water actually contain the same fish or have the same filtration requirements. However, it will serve as a general rule of thumb. With that said, I did dedicate an entire chapter in my book that goes over all of the details of things just like this. Now, one of the greatest things about building your own canister is the fact that there is no real rules for supplies that you must use or configurations that you must follow. So use this video to inspire ideas of your own, or at the very least, try new things and find out what works best for you. Anyways, hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. I also wanted to thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next week for a new do-it-yourself project.